Hello there, everyone. Welcome back to Broly 555 TV, and welcome to my series of videos playing NCAA College Football 2K3. Now, normally I would be live streaming this instead of doing an offline upload later on, but my OBS is having trouble connecting to Joshua TV for the purposes of streaming. So until that gets sorted out, I'm just going to have to make this as an offline recording that I upload later. So we're going to go ahead and start up our game right now with PCSX2 1.6. So make sure we got the right game turned on. Yes, we do. And our video plugin, is it what we want it to be? Yes, it is. All right, let's do this. We'll go ahead and let the intro play because it's a cool intro.
It's college football time again to renew old rivalries and begin new ones, in time for SportsCenter's season preview. Presents NCAA College Football 2K3.
Yeah, that's a cool intro, not gonna lie. All right, let's close that. Hello, Eric Crouch. Oh, I like this game. Oh, I like it oh so much. We're gonna load. We're gonna load our settings again just to be sure. And then we're going to load up our legacy mode here. And so for those of you who don't know, and you haven't watched my first two videos, I am playing as the Oregon Ducks on the legacy mode of NCAA College Football 2K3. As you can see, just like NFL Primetime, this game has the whole ESPN look down pat. At least the look that ESPN had 20 years ago. So we're right in the middle of things, and today I got a fairly easy game, or at least theoretically what should be a very easy game. I have a home game against the Samford Bulldogs. In my opening game, I beat Mississippi State 42-14, and in my previous game, I beat Idaho 41-17. And now, here I stand today, getting ready to play Samford, and hopefully I'll beat them soundly. Idaho actually gave me a game for almost three quarters before I pulled away from them, so we'll just go ahead and see what happens here. Here we go. All right. ESPN. Do-do-do-do-do-do.
Hello and welcome to Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon. The leaves are beginning to turn as we enter autumn time, and it's week five of NCAA college football action. Jake Sorensen here, along with the esteemed Jim Peppers. Oregon is the home team. What can we expect from them today, Jim?
Jake, one of the major keys of this team is their pass defense. They excel at shutting down the pass, and their opponent is likely to have problems moving the ball throughout the air today.
Samford is their opponent today. How do they stack up?
The matchup to watch today will be how this team handles the opposition's passing attack. Now, if they can keep them from breaking any big plays, they just might turn the tide.
Great stuff, Jimmy. Let's head to midfield for the opening toss.
As you can see, the broadcasting in this game, overall presentation is very good. And two, Samford ain't very talented. They're one stars across the board, except for a linebacker and kicking. All right, well. Here we go.
Number 25 sets up and is ready to kick it away to start the game.
Well, off on that.
There's the kick. Number 22 catches it.
There we go.
Number 21 comes in and makes the tackle on the return. First down.
Of course, in real life in this year, Oregon played Portland. In real life in this year, Oregon played Portland State instead of Samford, but
30-yard line.
Samford's about the same level, or at least in theory they are. Oh, I got Igor Oshansky back. Oh, get crushed, boy.
To the outside by the D. They really showed their speed by closing all of the lanes down before the runner could see any daylight to cut to.
It's now second and 12.
Well, let's not give up a whole ton of rushing yards today, ladies.
He's pressured.
Oh, get crushed. Get crushed, little girl. What you going to do? What you going to do, says number 40.
Number 40 really hunts down his blocker there. Watch this knot. Huge push there, Jake.
If you're on the offense, you do not want to be the ones reeling and reacting.
No, you don't want the defense whistling the tune that everybody's dancing to.
It's third and
19. Well, we're just going to make this third and forever. Come on, D.
He's pressured. Number 12 on the rollout.
There you go.
Incomplete.
There we go. Quick three and out.
Where he was supposed to be near the sideline, but couldn't close the deal.
And of course, I am ranked. Well, I guess I didn't show you before we played, but I am ranked number 15 in the country in both the coaches and media's poll.
Number 19 will punt it away after a three and out.
Which. Yeah, I'm behind the Washington schools, but I'm in a pretty good position poll-wise.
Number 15 has it.
There we go.
Makes the tackle on the return.
Good job, Keenan Howery.
They're going to start at midfield. Terrific field position. It sure makes it easier to score when you get to play half the field, Jake.
Ball on the 47.
All right, let's get this party going. Boston College leading Miami.
Number two with the kick.
There we go.
Number three makes the tackle after several yards on the play.
That 5 yards off the bat. The two gap, but instead he took it way left and made some room for himself. You know, it's unusual to see a run make yards where it's not designed to go.
Ball at the 42-yard line.
Yep. Ontario Smith's having quite the season so far.
Number two is
the
single
he's played just
setback.
Two games. But we're going to let this play clock run down to 1 second. Man, Minnesota's crushing Buffalo. Man.
Third down.
They really got me on that
one.
The same
play based on the results the first time, but the defense was not about to fall for it twice.
So we're looking for square or we're scrambling. Square, scramble. That's my philosophy on this play.
Number 12 is flushed out.
Oh, wow. Wide open. Come on, big boy. Get it. Oh, he almost got in the end zone. Wow.
Number 41.
I guess they forgot he existed. I don't know. Watch this. I almost forgot he existed. There for the first. Wait, you know what?
The Ducks have a first
here we
after
go.
The big pass on that last play. Number 41 will sit this play out.
Let's see if we can punch this in if Ontario Smith.
Gets a block. Number two.
And he walks right in the end
zone.
There we go.
Number two is in the end zone for the TD before
go.
The defense can react. There's the score. Nice play.
Good block by number 60. That's a great block by 60 right there at the center.
Number 25 will line up for the point after.
All right, that didn't take very long for us to score in this game. Boom!
25-7-0. Extra point. Oregon puts up the first points of the game. They lead 7-0.
I like the music in the stadium too. It's the stadium models in general and player models. This game just looks so lifelike,
number
especially when it's rendered in full 1080p HD. I mean, it's like, why would you want to play a modern football game as far
number
as Madden Land or
the
later NCAA
the
games?
Number 44 comes in and
although in their
the
defense, the
return.
NCAA football games were pretty good, especially in the late PS2 era and in
anything can still happen
the end
in this
of their
game,
run.
Folks. Let's see if they can take it back down the field with a touchdown of their own here.
Ball on the 27.
But, yep, we got off to a good start with this offense.
The Bulldogs are going with four wideouts.
Come on, D.
Number 12 drops back. He's pressured, dumps it off.
There
we
go.
Number 88 was the intended receiver. Incomplete.
Number 12 thought his receiver had a fair shot at it, but the coverage was just too tight.
You've got to admire a secondary that sticks with him that close. Second and 10.
Their quarterback's actually having a pretty solid season overall.
The Bulldogs line up with their tight end left.
Oh, there we go.
Nails him after a couple of yards.
Took the pitch way out left past the tackle, and he gets a few.
6 yards to go.
It's now third and 6.
Come on, defense. Let's get off the field again. Come on, D.
Number 12 steps back. Nice block. Throws middle. The
pass there we go, 22.
Number
22. Fourth down.
Positioned himself perfectly to act as a human fence between the quarterback and the receiver and caused the incompletion. Very impressive.
All right, they're
number
punting the ball again.
Comes in to punt after a three and out.
Man.
Nice Boom. Punt. Number 15 makes the catch.
Man, what a punt return by Howery that was.
The tackle on the return.
Yeah, way to celebrate, Keenan.
Pretty impressive scoring on their last possession. They have the ball. Let's see if they can do it again.
Ball at the 40-yard line.
Oh, they stood me up after 4 yards.
Right and picked up a handful.
Do, 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 do.
Second down. 6 yards to go.
Ball on the 44.
Yep. Ontario's off to a slow start. Hopefully we can bust a big one or two with him like we did against Idaho. All right, here we go. Burning some clock. It's scramble out or hit square.
He's pressured. Number 12 rolls out.
Oh, dang it. I saw a triangle. He was open. All right. I'm going to try.
It's third and about seven.
They are just leaving the tight end open. If I didn't have that guy properly pursuing my quarterback, I would have hit that tight end.
Formation.
All right. So we're going to hit triangle or scramble out. Oh, come on!
Number 15 saw that one come way in front of him.
Where am I?
If he knew it was coming, the receiver might have been able to sprint forward and snag it.
Yeah, but he was totally caught by surprise. They need to get on the same page.
Dang it.
Number 38 will punt it away after a three and out. There's the punt.
Pretty comfortable with my defense so far in this game, so.
Number 28 makes the stop on the return.
Boy, Jake, talk about having a hard time moving the ball. This offense has yet to see a first down this game, and I imagine it's getting pretty frustrating.
Ball at the 23-yard line.
It's only a one-score game, though.
Have their tight end to the right. Flag on the play.
I screwed that one up.
Encroachment. Defense.
Come on, defense, no penalties.
Number 53 was not where he was supposed to be and drew the encroachment penalty.
All right, whatever you say, bro.
Ball on the 28.
And we got to get the ball back on offense. I need a real do-over.
Number 53 gets set after committing the penalty.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
That was designed to go through the two gap, but he tried to go somewhere else, and look what happened. It's all about following your blockers.
4 yards to go. Second and four.
All right, defense, come on. Let's get a stop.
Number 12 drops back. Oh, great block. Bro.
Really? Come on, guys. You had this dude covered. You literally had him covered.
First down. 10 yards to go.
Ball at the 49-yard line.
Man, this sucks.
Number one is to the left.
Penalty
flag down. Let's find out.
Probably
what
a holding.
Holding.
Yep.
Offense.
You're right. I'll take first and 20.
Dogs are playing some slapdash offense. You know, it's bad enough they can't make the plays, but to draw a flag on top of that.
Ball on the 39.
All right, defense, come on.
Number one gets set after committing the penalty. Gets a block. Number 34.
Ooh, look at that hit. Just put 34 down for the count.
Second down. 20 yards to go.
Second and 20.
Yeah, the game speed's running a lot better today for some reason on this game. I wonder if it's because I'm not streaming it. Eh, whatever.
Number 12 fades back. He's pressured. Throw.
Jeez.
Third and short.
Jeez. What is going on in my defense?
Third down.
Making these guys look like world beaters.
Third and one. Number 88 will sit this play out.
Oh, yeah. Tackle for loss. Good job. I think Kevin Mitchell is who you are.
Number 39 locks the door on that play and forces
there you
a
go.
Tough fourth down. When you
oh.
Yeah, sweet job there.
He was all over that.
Great job, man.
Start to finish.
That is a great tackle by the linebacker there. You gonna punt it? There we go.
Number 19 sets up for his third punt of the game. Number 15 has it.
Nice return, bro.
Number 35 will make the tackle on the return.
It's their turn on offense. Let's see what they do.
Ball at the 31-yard line. The Ducks are going with three wide receivers. Escapes out of the backfield.
Come on, Ontario Smith. There you go. Bust 40, the big one. 30, you can't keep up with 15, Ontario Smith.
And he's in.
Touchdown, Ontario Smith.
Number two was on full throttle from all the
way
back. Keeps going, and touchdown.
Great job. He never flagged and never let the defense become a factor.
Yeah, that's how you do it, Ontario. You're the man.
Number 25 lines up for the point after.
Yep, your face looks super realistic, Jared Siegel. Boom! Extra point, good.
25 adds the extra point.
14-0 late in the first quarter. I am off to a great start so far.
Oregon makes it a two-score game.
69-yard TD run by Ontario. Well, that takes care of the big plays.
Number 25 will kick this one away.
Jared Siegel to the rescue. Boom.
Good kick here. Number 22 fields it in the end zone.
Oh.
Number 7 with the tackle.
Get mauled.
On the return
man. Get mauled. That is incredible.
Not much production out of the running game today. The problem is they still have to try it if they want to keep the defense honest.
Ball on the 22. The Bulldogs
All right, D.
have two receivers in.
Oh, geez. Nice run by the quarterback.
Several on the play.
This was designed to go way out to the six gap, but he took it elsewhere. He did pick up yards, however, thanks to some fancy feet and a little luck.
It's second and 5.
All right, D, come on. Let's get him off the field again.
Number 12 lines up under center.
There we go. Good
makes
tackle.
The stop before he could get very far. Third and 4.
All right, 44 is having a big game today. Come on, D. Come on. Oh, you got crushed. Oh, their quarterback's hurt. Oh, poor fella. Hurt his wrist on that play.
Number 19 comes in to punt after a 3-and-out.
Man, this guy's got quite the leg.
It's away.
I was going to fair catch this one.
Number 15 reels in the fair catch.
Last time out, these boys went straight down the field for a touchdown.
Let's run that play again that just got us a touchdown.
Ball at the 36-yard line. The Ducks have one man back. Number 2 with the ball. There's space.
Oh, yeah. Ontario Smith again.
Touchdown.
Ontario Smith.
Another touchdown.
Three in the first quarter.
End zone today.
Number 2 saw his moment and took it.
Oh, my goodness.
He motors his way forward, getting yard after yard after yard and in for the touchdown. Great play.
Fantastic run, Jim. That has to be incredibly satisfying to pull a runoff like that, not just for the runner, but for the entire team.
Everybody loves a play like that, except the defense.
Number 25.
Man, what a game he's having.
Point after.
Yeah. Wobuski.
25, 21-0
late in the first. Wow, what a play by Ontario.
Have a substantial margin on the scoreboard.
64-yard touchdown run. Holy smokes. 130. He's got like 140-some rushing yards and three scores in the first quarter.
Number 25 is back to kick it away.
Boom.
Nice kickoff. Number 22 makes the catch. 20. Number 44
there
comes
we go.
In makes the tackle on the return.
Great tackle.
Well, they got the ball, but they are really in a hole early in this game. They can't let this game get away from them early on.
They don't really have much of a choice in the matter.
There's a penalty on the play. Let's
so that's what that
call.
Button does.
Encroachment.
Okay, I will do that again.
Focus, focus.
Yeah, we got to focus
here. Number 44
here.
Has got to watch where he
Repeat,
is on the field
touchdown.
There. That was clearly encroachment.
Ball at the
Let's try that again.
Line. Number 44 gets set after
All right,
committing
D,
the
come
penalty.
Come on, let's get a stop.
He's pressured. Number 16.
Oh, nice tackle by number 42.
Makes the tackle in the backfield, and that'll push him back for a loss.
Good tackle, bro.
Number 42 is going to fly into the backfield untouched at full speed and just clobbers the quarterback. Check out that replay.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
my, that can't
That's
be
how
pleasant.
You do it.
Somebody must have blown an assignment there. It's not often you see someone get into the backfield scot-free like that.
Yeah, for the quarterback's sake, hopefully he won't be seeing it again anytime soon.
It's now second and
Good
12.
Job, 42.
Number 31, we'll run it. It'll be third down.
Damn.
Carried this one away right. Made a pretty nice run. Good yards off second down.
Gain of six on the play.
It's now third and six.
All right, let's see where we're at.
Number 31 lines up left. Number 16.
Oh, get crushed.
Fourth and long.
Get crushed by 43. Defensive end. Let's see this
Number
replay.
Number 43. Just deep six the offense momentum here with a decisive stop in the backfield. Let's watch. A great tackle.
It's got to be rewarding to railroad a play like that. The defensive coordinator should be very happy with how they played that down.
Instant replays in this game are just downright beautiful. Not going to lie.
Number 19 will punt for the fifth time. Nice punt.
I'm going to fair catch this one, too.
Number 15 hauls in the fair catch.
Good job, Keenan Howery. You hardly have to even lift a finger today.
They put themselves in the driver's seat early, and they have
You know what?
They
worked two times
Let's
in
see
a
if
row.
They continue their success
Could it work
the ball.
A third?
Ball on the 40.
Guess we're about to find out. Oh, only 5 yards. Oh, what a shame.
It's the end of the first quarter. Oregon is running away with this one, 21-0.
Yep, we're playing as well as can be, so I'm scoring so fast that I'm actually losing time of possession for the game. That's amazing. Normally, that's a category I dominate.
Oh, the 46-yard line.
Seven carries, 151, and three scores for Ontario Smith already.
Number two is the lone back.
So I'm scrambling out and I'm hitting square triangle. We'll see if they leave triangle wide open again.
He's pressured. Nice block. Number 12 on the rollout.
And we're just going to scramble for it. First down.
To the marker, but I think he has enough. Yes, it's a first down.
Good job, buddy. Actually, you know what?
Ball on the 49. He's pressured. Bro, it's caught sideline.
Come on, Keenan Howery. First down. And more.
15.
He didn't have. Oh, almost got
nice
in the end
catch
zone.
And an even nicer run after the catch. Gets a first down.
Number 15 makes the catch, but man, oh man, the best is yet to come. Whoosh. Golden Gloves waits until he has the ball, and bam, he's off and running.
Golden Gloves, how about Golden Feet? Terrific job at both
That
ends.
Is quite the run after catch there. I thought I was going to get into the end zone.
The Ducks, after the big pass last play, will have a first down.
All right, well, I think we're going to do square if we can.
Number 15 is to the left. Number 12 is back to throw again. Number 12 rolls out. Dumps it left.
Oh, Howry, you dropped it, bro.
Swung around to the outside, but unfortunately the pass was outside his hands.
It's second and goal.
All right, well.
Number 12 will put it in the air again. Number 12 rolls outside. Throw.
And there you go. Touchdown. We corrected that mistake.
Number 12 locks onto his receiver and puts it in there. Watch this.
Boom.
Zipped it right by the defender.
He was licking his chops on that one. He saw the single coverage that he wanted and puts it on the money.
Terrific throw. He put it where only the receiver could catch that one.
Number
All right, well, this is getting so
point.
Ugly. We might have the starters out by halftime at the rate we're going. All right, here we go.
There's the kick.
Extra point, good.
25 adds the extra
Early
point.
Second quarter, and we're up 28-0 already. Oh, my.
Oregon widens the gap on a huge lead even more. They're up 28-0.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yep, I am digging these stadium models.
Number 25.
Not quite as good as NFL 2K5 stadium models, but they're pretty darn good.
This will send them deep. Number 35 catches it in the end zone. The 20.
Oh, there you go.
Makes the tackle on the return.
I am playing with some fierce aggression on offense.
Well, Jake, there is time left in the game, but they are fading fast and can't waste time. This is an important drive.
Ball at the 25-yard line.
Yeah, you're not winning today. I'm ranked number 15 for a reason, boys. Even though I lost a lot of talent for the NFL, I still got a bunch of it left. Oh, geez.
The tackle.
You got clobbered.
Number 3 for the game.
The defense really strutted their stuff on that run there. They showed both their speed and tackling ability by shutting down the outside and bringing the runner down for a loss.
It's second and 11.
Alrighty.
The Bulldogs go with a twin back set.
Tennessee beat Florida 47-41.
Number 16 steps back, dumps it off.
Oh, geez, how did he complete that?
The day.
They dump off over
oh,
the middle
man.
And complete it for a handful. Why not enough for the first, however, and we'll You're be
right.
seeing third down right here.
It's now third and 6.
All right, boys, let's get a stop. Come on.
Number 34.
With oh, the carry. Man.
Moves wide right.
Come on, defense.
The, 40, the 30, 20, the 15. 5.
Jeez.
And he scores.
Dang it, I gave up a score. On a run,
Number
no less.
Number 34 was on full throttle from all the way back. Keeps going, and touchdown.
Great job. He never flagged and
well,
never
the
let the defense become a factor.
The bad news is you have to defend my offense again. Sucks to be you.
Number 49 lines up for the point after.
Oh, that sucks to give up a score this early.
It's up. 49 is good for the extra point. Samford cuts into the score a bit, but they've still got a substantial deficit to overcome. They're down 28-7.
Giving up a 71-yard touchdown run to Samford, though, is not a good feeling.
Lines up, signals,
not
and
at
we're
all.
Ready for the kickoff. The kick is up. Number 15 catches it deep. Number 30 makes the stop on the return.
They get yet another shot at scoring here. And while it's far from over yet, it's going to take a lot to stop these guys. They are well in control so far.
Ball on the 29.
Oh, hey, whoa. Well, hey, shut that down.
Good job coming off the blocks by the defense. Well, they came through and stopped that run in its tracks.
13 yards to go. Ball at the 26-yard line.
Oh, boy.
The Ducks are going with a two tight end set. He's pressured. Number 12 on the rollout. Passes left.
Ah, oh, there we go.
Tackle, but he was able to get his third reception of the game.
Boom.
They zip this one left side after the rollout and get the completion for several yards. Not enough for the first, but still a nice gain.
It's third and about three.
All right, here we go.
Number 15 is wide right.
We're either going to scramble for the first down or we're going to hit triangle, which is Keenan Howry. I guess we'll see which one happens first.
Number 12 will throw once again. He's pressured, drops way back. Bro.
There we go. What?
The D gave up a few, but still managed to keep them short of the markers. Good work to force fourth
down. No way. 1 yard to go. I'm going for this one.
It looks like they'll go for it on fourth and about a foot.
I'm either scrambling for it or I'm hitting B.
Number 12 will pass again. Gets a block. Number 12 rolls out.
Yeah! Keenan Howry says, I got the first down. Because I'm all American and you're not.
Number 12 was feeling the heat on fourth down, but didn't back down. Watch this. A nice throw, and his receiver makes the catch to move the chains.
I'm going to guess this guy sleeps real good the night before his end. He doesn't seem to feel pressure at all.
Oh, he feels it. What makes him a great quarterback is that he doesn't let it affect his play.
Jim, that was not necessarily a safe call, but it was a successful call. What do you think about going for it on fourth
versus time of possession back in
our
favor.
Well, it was a risky call, one that I wouldn't have made, but hey, that's why I'm in the booth and not on the sidelines.
Ball on the 44.
All right. Well. Jeez, now they're focusing on me.
That play was designed to go through the one gap, but he took it a mile to the right of that. Well, Jake, if you're not going where your blockers are leading you, you're going to go nowhere.
Second and 10.
Well, at least Ontario's still having a monster game. All right, almost halfway through the quarter, and I'm up 28-7. That's a good position to be in.
He's pressured. Nice block. Tosses right. Caught in the
There
flat.
You go, Keenan Howry. Big play.
He's down, but he's first been a down. Target today. That's his sixth catch.
Excellent reception.
Makes a nice reception, but he makes an even nicer play afterwards. Here's the catch, and now he's going to pick up a bunch more.
That's just great instinct to turn that one upfield. Some of these young receivers think the play ends when they catch the ball.
Well, obviously, this kid, he's not one of them. He turned and burned.
Ball at the 29-yard line.
All right. Burn some more
Number
time
15
here.
Number 15 lines up left.
Looks like they're playing up on the run right now, so we're just going to have to aerate it out. I'm going to scramble out with Fife. I'm going to hit square or I'm going to hit triangle. And only if triangle's wide open.
Number 12, he's back to throw again. He's pressured. Number 12 rolls outside. Throws.
Oh, catch the ball. You were open,
dude. Number 41 couldn't make the catch, Jake, although he looked ready for it.
Some wires got crossed there. That ball was significantly to the right of where the receiver was.
Let's try this.
Ball on the 29. Nothing, baby. Down. The Ducks have their tight end to the left. Number two with the ball.
Dang, they're just coming for me now.
Took this one off his right guard. And he gets almost nothing. Boy, he needed a lot more than that for the first down.
It's third. I'm going to hit square on this one if I can. I'm either going to scramble out with five, hit square, or if triangle's an option if he's super wide open. Because apparently he can't have anyone near him if he's going to catch a pass.
He's pressured.
Oh my gosh, no one blocked.
Nice play.
No one blocked. Literally no one blocked.
Number 17 is going to benefit from a well-coordinated blitz watch. Perfectly executed, and the quarterback goes down.
There's nothing I could have done on that play. I mean, he was there as soon as the ball was hiked.
On 4th and 13, they're going to go for it.
Yeah, I don't trust my kicker at this point.
He's pressured. 12 rolls out, throws middle.
Yeah, tight end comes through on fourth down.
Terrific execution, and that will keep the drive alive.
Number 12 comes through with a big time pass on fourth down. He stayed collected.
There we go. Look at this pass.
Fantastic throw, Jim. He knew what the situation was. Stayed calm and made a nice throw to convert.
Good job, 41.
The Ducks have a first down after the big fourth down conversion.
All right, Fife, you're doing an excellent job today. We're going to scramble out with you or hit Keenan Howery.
Number 41, preferably hit Keenan Howery.
All right, here we go.
Number 12 will put it in the air again. He's pressured, dumps it right.
There we go. Oh, dang it.
He continues to turn up the heat with his seventh grab of the day.
He just went over the 100-yard receiving mark for the game. A good day for any receiver.
Second and about a foot.
There we go, Keenan Howery.
Number 15 is to the left.
I'm hoping to hit square or I can run it in with Fife himself. I guess we'll see which one happens. Or if triangle's wide open again, I'll hit him.
Number 12 will throw once again. He's pressured. Number 12 on the roll.
And I'm going to scramble it in.
And he's in for the
Jason
score.
Fife with the touchdown.
Number 12 had just a few strides to go and takes it in himself.
Boom.
There's the score. Got to be happy with that one.
Obviously, that puts the quarterback in a vulnerable spot. But on those short ones, he can get in before the D really catches on.
It took away my receiving options to let me walk into the end zone.
Number 25 will line up for the point after.
Do, 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 do. Here we go. Boom. 35-7.
On the extra point.
Doo-doo.
Oregon, with that score, are simply crushing their
opponent.
12
plays, 71 yards, almost 6 minutes. That's typical me right there.
Number 25 will kick this one away.
There's no win today. Huh.
This is a good kick. Number 35 fields it. The 25.
Ooh, get crushed.
The tackle on the return.
Yeah, you make sure that arm of yours still works.
Jake, first play of the drive. Let's see what they do.
Ball at the 28-yard line.
All right, D.
He's pressured. Bro.
Come on. Gotta stop plays like that, guys.
First down. 10 yards to go.
on the 40.
Jeez.
Number 34 is off the left tackle.
There we go.
34 applies the brakes yet again. His sixth tackle, second and eight. The Bulldogs are going with their tight end right. Number 16 rolls out.
Oh, I got so lucky there.
Receiver on that play, incomplete.
Number 88 was in nice shape there if he'd caught it, Jake, but it just didn't happen.
Not only would have made the catch for some big yards, but he could have picked up plenty more, too. Third and eight. Snakes out of the backfield.
Oh, my gosh.
40.
Jeez. Run over by Samford all of a sudden.
Big gain on the third down play to get the first down and a whole lot more.
I was shutting these guys down. They're just running all over me.
Number 34 lines up behind the quarterback. He's pressured.
Oh, yeah, get there.
Stop it. His seventh tackle of the game. Ball on the 46. The Bulldogs will go with two wide receivers. Crosses middle.
There we go. Third and 18.
Very long.
Number four positioned himself perfectly.
I'm
going to
bring the heat again.
Fence between the quarterback and the receiver and
caused the incompletion. Don't jiggle on me.
Very impressive.
Third and 18. Number 16 will put it up again.
Oh, get crushed.
Fourth and very, very
I'm taking
long.
The timeout.
Oregon exercises their first timeout.
Why they're winning. Watch this sack here. Bam. They've been doing that all day long.
Boom. Man, I just love the gameplay in this game.
The clock is down to a minute 18. Number 19
see if
lines
we can get
up,
a score before the half.
This will be his sixth punt of the game. It's off. Number 15 catches it.
All right, there we go.
25. Number 22 makes the tackle, but not before a great return.
All right,
some nice open field running there. Ball at the 37-yard line. The Ducks set up in the eye. He's pressured. Oh, great block. Throws right.
Yeah, Keenan Howery gets open.
Nice game receiving. That's his eighth catch.
I think they found something going to the air here. They're picking apart the secondary.
Jim, if they can get another 10 or 15 yards here, they can at least try for a field goal before the half. He's pressured. Number 12 rolls outside. Bro.
Yeah, tight end again. That guy's having a monster game because he keeps getting left open.
Number 12 drew a solid.
Look at this guy.
Watch right by the defender.
Ball on the 24.
All right, let's get our hurry up going.
Number 41 will sit this play out. He's pressured, drops way back. Bro, the pass ball's incomplete.
Number two seemed to be open, but just wasn't able to make the catch.
You know, those passes are sometimes surprisingly tough to get right, Jim.
Yeah, well, I'm sure their coach is going to devote some extra practice time next week to make sure they do get it right.
32 seconds left. The Ducks have three wideouts on the field. Number 43 makes the stop.
All right, here
Oregon
we go.
Will take a timeout, and that will be their second. It's
at least I got a positive run there by Ontario.
Number two is the lone setback. Pressure gets a block. Short throw down the middle.
There we go.
Hit, but manages to just convert the third and short. Nice play for the first down.
Got several there and picked up the first. Nice pass.
Ball at the 11-yard line. Number 12 will put it in the air again. He's pressured. Bro, caught sideline.
Down,
but now has an impressive 10 receptions on the day. Oregon takes their third and final timeout. Just 11 seconds remaining. The Ducks line up with a single setback. He's pressured. Number 12 on the rollout. Tosses left.
There we go. Touchdown.
Finds the end zone again, Jake.
I think my tight end was open too, but that works.
Touchdown reception of the game.
One is nice, but two is even nicer, Jim.
Yep.
I think he could get used to this.
All righty.
Number 25 sets up the extra point.
There we go. Nice extra point.
There's the kick.
Boom.
25 adds the extra point.
There we go.
Oregon.
Whoa, that was a
this has become a
little
blowout.
Glitch there
They're
in the emulator.
42-7.
All right, here we go.
Number 25 lines up for the kickoff.
No. Boom.
Gets his foot into it, and this is a nice kickoff. Number 35 is backed all the way into his end zone for the catch.
There we go.
With the tackle on the return man.
This team has really been struggling to get the passing game going today. They might want to try a couple of high percentage plays, if nothing else, to
boost
their confidence.
All right, last play of the first half.
Ball on the 25. Number 16 takes back, dumps it off.
Oh, there we
incomplete.
Go. Good tip. And it's halftime. 42-7
lead. It's the end of the first half. Oregon is punishing their opponent with a blowout. 42-7.
Got 379 total offense. Bounce, throw, and run. Yeah, we're doing good. And I'm winning time of possession again, thank goodness. All right, now let's go to our stats. 14 of 18, 220, two scores, no picks. 11 for 56. I think we'll keep my starters in a little bit more. But we are going to go to the subs in the third quarter at some point. And those are your halftime stats. Yep, third quarter. Here we go.
Number 49 sets up and will kick it away to start the third quarter. It's away. Number 8 fields it deep. 30. Number 30 comes in and makes the tackle on the return.
Good job, Kevin Willis.
They've got the ball again and are comfortably in the driver's seat. It's never over till it's over, but they are looking good for this one.
Ball at the 33-yard line.
Let's go. Down. Ace, tight right, tight right. Oh, dang. Well, 5 yards is good.
He was supposed to take that one off of right guard, but instead he took it way left and made some room for himself. You know, it's unusual to see a run make yards where it's not designed to go. They're showing their big play ability once again and getting excellent production out of the backfield.
Yes, we are.
Number 2 is the single
setback. Scramble out with Fife, or I'm going to hit square, or I'm going to hit triangle. That's basically it.
He's pressured. Nice block. Number 12 rolls out. Bro.
Oh! It was wide open, bro. You couldn't have been more open.
These are the kind of plays that
oh
give
my
offensive
gosh.
Coordinators gray hair. It was executed nicely until the end. Watch here. It's there, but the receiver just couldn't handle it.
Oh, boy. He had a ton of open field in front of him.
Man. Dude.
It's third and 5. Let's play smart. Number 12 will put it up again. He's pressured. Number 12 rolls outside.
Oh, dang it. I whiffed
down
that
the
one.
General for his second sack
I scrambled
of the day.
Too much. That was my fault.
He's got to get rid of that football faster than that, Jake, or I'll tell you what.
Yeah, I need to get rid of that. That is true. Yeah, I'm going to have to punt this one away.
Number 38 is ready to punt after a quick three and out.
Boom.
Good punt here. Number 35 has it. Number 31 makes the tackle on the return.
They had him sewn up tight, almost allowing no time for a return. There's the hit. That's some heads-up coverage by the punt squad.
Excuse me.
They've got to put something together here and get a score to keep this from getting completely out of reach, Jake.
Ball on the 30.
Come on, defense.
He's pressured.
Oh, get crushed.
Stops that play. Get crushed, bro. Started and forces a loss of a couple of yards.
Good job, 43.
If they end up winning this game, the defense should get a good portion of the credit for their onslaught on the quarterback today. And here they take
it. Everyone wanted to shot that guy.
You know, Jim, tomorrow's when the quarterback's really going to feel all these sacks.
Oh, no doubt about it. Let me tell you, I've been there, and it always hurts more the next day.
Second and 14.
All right, good job, number 43.
The Bulldogs line up with four wideouts. He's pressured. Number 12 on the rollout.
Gosh darn it, guys. Come on.
Like he just got enough for the first down.
Come on.
Ball at the 40-yard line.
That was right in the spot that was supposed to be covered. What's wrong with
number
you people?
Number 82 will sit this play out.
All right. Let's see what we can do here.
Escapes out of the backfield.
Holding.
Let's get the call.
Holding.
Holding.
Yep.
Offense.
I'm going to accept that penalty.
Number one penalty. Obviously didn't have his man if he had to resort to offensive holding like that. Good call.
Ball on the 30. Number 31 is to the right. He's pressured. Spirals it middle. Tip.
There we go.
Number 12 looked a little jumpy there and overthrew his receiver.
Second and 20.
Good job, Keith Lewis, with the tip. All right, let's try and get a stop here.
Number 12 will pass again. He's pressured. Tosses middle.
There we go. Third and 13.
That tackle, his fourth.
Out of play action, they dump it out over the middle and complete it for a couple. But there's still a ways to go to move the chains.
It's third and about 13.
All right. Here we go. Fresno State beat Oregon State 27-24. Ooh.
Number 12 is back to throw again. He's pressured. Number 12 is chased out of the
pocket. Oh, come on! You were there! Why won't you make a play? First down. 10 yards
to go. Ball at the 48-yard line.
My defender could have knocked that down. He's like, derpa derpa derp. I'm not going to defend anybody. Oh, yeah, there you go.
Really nice to see the D step up on first down and make the nice stop to the outside. Quick reflexes.
Ball on the 50.
All right, here we go. Come on, defense. We got to get a stop.
The Bulldogs go with one man back. Number 12 steps back. He's pressured, sits in the pocket.
There we go.
Third and long coming up.
Number 12 thought he had a good read, but he didn't count on such great zone coverage.
Terrific coverage, Jim. It was only single zone, but it was effective.
Yeah, give that defender a pat on the back. He did a great job.
It's now third and 12.
Come on, D. You got to stop here on third and long.
Number 12 will put it in the air again. Short throw down the middle.
There we go.
That will fall incomplete.
Defense.
And that's their second in a row.
Number 44 managed to cut off the line from the QB to the receiver by putting his body in the path. That was crafty pass defense. There's no way the ball was getting to the receiver.
Number 19 is ready for his seventh punt of the game. Number 15 makes the catch. The 35,
there
number
we go.
15, picked up some decent yardage before running out of bounds. Nice return.
Time for the offense to do their job. Let's check them out.
Ball at the 37-yard line.
Wow, that was supposed to be a run.
That one through the four gap, but he tried to go somewhere else, and look what happened. It's all about following your blockers.
10 yards to go. Second and 10. The Ducks. Tight end is lined up left side. Number 2 gets it again.
Oh, come on.
Third and long.
Oh, my. Nice play by the defense. They picked the runner up quickly and stopped him in his tracks.
Third and 10.
Smart D, don't give up the pass.
All right, we can do this.
He's pressured. Number 12 rolls out. Spirals it left. That'll bring up short.
I'm going for it.
Fourth down.
They're going for it on fourth and one.
Scrambling for it, or I'm hitting triangle.
Number 15 lines up wide right. 12 is back to throw again. He's pressured.
Oh, he wouldn't throw. It's not fair. I hit the triangle button after letting go of the sprint, and he didn't move out of sprint, and he wouldn't let me throw.
However,
he was wide open.
The offense takes the field after a great defensive stop. Let's see.
I had a great first half on offense, and now I'm laying a big old turd. I was going to get one more score with my starters before I put my backups in.
Number 34, will run it. Number 39 hammers him after a couple of yards.
Carried this one off his left guard and gets a few.
I do not like this game sometimes.
Ball at the 42-yard line.
As much as I love playing this game's gameplay, it is not perfect. It has moments that are frustrating. Oh, get crushed.
Number 39.
Look at this play.
Knocks him back a few yards as we see the great tackle.
It's now third and 12.
All right, Washington State beat Boise State 29-20.
Number 12 drops back.
Come on now.
Throws middle.
There we go. Fourth down.
Number 88 was open over the middle. No excuses for not getting a completion there.
You better punt it. Thank you.
Number 19 will punt it away after a three and out. Number 15 fields it. Number 35 forces him out only after a very good return. Good special teams play.
All right, ball, I'm hitting Howie right off the bat.
The Ducks line up with two wideouts. He's pressured. Tosses right. Caught in the flat.
First down.
Manages a few more yards on his
own. There we go.
Nice moves, and that'll give him the first.
After the scramble, they throw it right side of the field and complete it for a healthy gain. More importantly, however, they move the chains. Nice play. He is a load to take down once he gets going, and you can see he's definitely got it going.
Number 15 is wide right.
Do, 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 do.
Snakes out of the backfield.
Well, there you go.
Makes the hit and takes it down after a handful of yards.
This O-line has been opening up some nice holes in the middle these past few plays. That's why I like that last run. Keep attacking the center of the line until they can stop you.
Second and four. Number two is the lone back. Oh, great block. Number 12 rolls outside.
There you go, Keenan Howery. Busted.
25.
Busted.
15.
Busted. Oh, he almost busted it to the end zone.
I'll tell you, he's caught just about everything thrown at him today.
Number 15 makes a brilliant leaping catch here. Oh, my, let's see that one again.
Look at that.
What a graceful looking catch. Where do they teach that kind of move?
Boy, I don't know, Jim. Maybe he's a gymnast in the offseason. I don't think they teach those kind of jumps in football.
Man. Oh my God, Keenan Howery again.
After the big pass on that last play. Number 15 lines up wide right. Number 12 will throw once again. He's pressured. Short throw to the right.
Boom. He's Keenan Howery.
And that's his third touchdown toss of the day.
Number 12 just puts this ball where only the receiver could catch it. We've got to see that again. Holy, perfect throw.
There was absolutely no margin of error on that throw, Jim.
Yeah.
And he pegged him for six.
You know, that gets my vote for All-American status. Wow.
Number 25 lines
up. There
we
go.
And
I think we're
after.
Done with the starters. I'm going to put my subs in after this extra point. Boom!
25-49-7.
Extra point. Yeah, you bobbed that head. All right, we're gonna put the. Actually, you know what? We're gonna put number 10 in because that's the guy that's actually better overall than number 13. And then I'm gonna put you in. I think you're the one that's a 69 overall. And then Howery, you're done, so I'm just going to move you down the list.
Michigan extends their lead by a big margin. They're ahead 49-7. Number 25 is back to kick it away.
There we go. Boom.
Got his leg behind this one. Number 22 fields it in the end zone.
Oh, there you go.
Makes the stop on the return.
It's usually a good day when you can reach that 100-yard mark, and that last carry just put him over. Nice job. This team has really been struggling to get the passing game going today. They might want to try a couple of high-percentage plays, if nothing else, to boost their confidence.
All right, here we go.
Ball at the 19-yard line.
See if he can play some defense.
Number 12 fades back, dumps it off.
There you go, nice tip.
Number 42 was the intended receiver, but the pass is off the mark and falls incomplete.
Number 42 had his turf in the middle, but the pass just didn't come together.
He really has to be the guy who his quarterback can rely on to make those.
Ball. Good job, Justin Finnessy. Whoa, what the? What is going off my game speed?
Line up with two tight ends.
All right, that was really weird. My game speed dipped down to 34% on that play.
Pressure spirals in middle.
Jeez, come on, guys.
First down.
Number 42 handles an overthrown catch like it was perfectly accurate.
Jeez.
Man alive, he spins in midair to make that catch.
Ball at the 33-yard line.
Come on, defense. Got to get off the field.
Number 42 is off the right tackle.
Back!
Number 12 steps back. Throws. Incomplete pass.
There
number
you go.
16 used his body as a shield to force that incompletion, and that's not as easy as he made it look. He had to make the read, react, then get to the right position to prevent the ball from getting to its target.
Second and 10.
All right, D, come on.
The Bulldogs line up with three wideouts. Number 12 will pass again. Throws middle.
There
the
we
pass
go.
Is incomplete.
Number 11 didn't have a chance on that one.
You make it very tough on your man when you throw it behind him like that.
Well, I'm sure he didn't do it on purpose. His arm just needs a little tweaking.
Third and 10.
Three tips today by Keith Lewis. That's pretty good.
Number 12 is back to throw again. He's pressured. Throw. Fourth down.
There we go.
That
fourth down.
Incompletions in a row. Not a good series for the offense.
Number 11 wasn't able to bring it down, but hey, it wasn't for a lack of effort, huh, Jake?
Nope. He got plenty of hang time in his attempt at the catch, but he came down empty-handed anyway. Number 19 lines up, and this will be his ninth punt of the game. There's the punt. Number
there
one signals
go.
And makes the catch.
They get yet another shot at scoring here. And while it's far from over yet, it's going to
all
take
right,
a lot
to
stop
time
these guys.
To do some hard
They're
running.
Well in control so far.
Ball on the 31.
Number
32
takes
him down quick. I don't think he got much, maybe a yard or two.
He was supposed to take that one off the right guard, but he was way too far to the left for his blockers to be useful. Well, you've got to stay behind
all right,
and let
we're gonna
them
either
work for you.
Hit square
ball at the
or hit triangle.
33-yard line.
Doubles, doubles wide right.
Yeah, your face is the doubles wide right. All right.
He's pressured. Number 10 on the rollout.
Oh, first down. Keenan Howery. Or not Keenan Howery. Sammy Parker. My bad.
This one left side
Parker's actually
rollout.
Faster than Keenan Howery.
The markers. Nice job.
Ball on the 41.
Do, 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 do.
Number one
do,
is
do,
to
do,
the
do,
left.
Boop, 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 boop. All right, we are doing a fantastic job with this.
Number 34. With the
dang, no one wants
on
to run
play.
Block
that
all of a sudden.
That play was designed to go through the one gap, but he was well right of his blockers, and if you're not going to follow them, don't be surprised when they're not there to help you.
They didn't show up, period. I didn't go where I needed to or wanted to.
Second and 10.
Quarterback, is it?
The Ducks line up in the eye. He's pressured. Dumps it right.
Oh.
Third and short.
Nice pass. And that will make this third down a whole lot easier coming up here.
It's third and two.
End of the quarter. 49-7.
It's the end of the third quarter. Oregon has completely dominated this game, and the score tells it all. They're up 49-7.
Well, I look like one of the most dominant teams in the country, that's for sure.
The good news is they're hitting the receivers. The bad news is they aren't hitting them very deep.
Number one,
I'm either gonna hit square or triangle.
Number 10 will put it in the air again. He's pressured, gets a block. Number
oh,
10
triangle's
out,
wide open.
Left.
Yeah, one, go big boy. Go big boy. Oh, got over 100 yards receiving though on the day.
Catch of the day.
Number 41 nabs the football for a nice reception right there. But the play doesn't stop there, Jake.
Nope, just the first act in a beautiful big yard play. A sterling effort all around.
Mm-hmm.
the Ducks. After the big pass last play, we'll have a first down. Number 41 will sit this play out. He's pressured. And he's
and he scores. Boom.
Number 10 gets in for the TD. Really just a few strides, and he's in pay dirt.
Pretty good call in close to the end zone. A power play was just what they needed.
Definitely, nothing's a gimme in this game. The team needed to be prepared to plow their way through.
And backup quarterback runs for a touchdown. It's just one of those days. Here we go. Boom. Extra point. Good.
Tacks on the extra point.
56-7, early fourth.
Oregon widens the gap on a huge lead even more. They're up 56-7.
Yeah, Samford's just so horrible. I knew I was going to beat him down like this. Although, to be honest, I thought I was going to beat Idaho down like this, so... Yeah, you just don't know what's going to happen.
He booms the kickoff. Number 22 catches
it. I have no idea what's going to happen when I actually start playing the tough teams on my schedule. These are all the easy games I've been playing so far.
Their passing game has not been pretty today. They really need to try something different and hope that they can get something going.
Ball at the 20-yard line.
All right, here we go.
Fumble!
We almost had that.
To the loose ball and maintain possession for the offense.
I want to see the replay. See if that hit was responsible for the fumble or not. Well, that's pretty clear. The hit definitely popped it out.
Well, that's what you want to do on defense. If the guy isn't holding on tightly, you want to make him pay for it. Ball on the 18.
All right, here we go.
Number 12 drops back. He's pressured. Bro.
Oh, geez.
Number 4 makes the hit.
They toss this one right side and complete it for a handful. Why, not enough for the first, however, and we'll be seeing third down right here.
Third and 4.
How about another?
Well, you're down by 49, so I don't think you're in the room to smack talk anybody.
Number 88 is to the left.
Oh, get him. Fourth down. Good job, number 40. I've been having one heck
number
of a game.
Number 19 comes in to punt after a three and out. Gets off a good one. Number
there
one
we
reels
go.
In the fair catch.
Well, the defense did their job and forced a three and out. Now it's the offense's turn.
Ball at the 33-yard line.
Oh, jeez. No one blocks.
Gotta
no
like
one
the
blocks.
Penetration by the D-line.
Hammonds is a 78 overall, but you wouldn't know it because no one's blocking for him.
It's second and 11.
I'm going to run you back for a couple more.
Oh, are you sure about that, 43? Do-do-do.
He's pressured. Short throw to the left.
Oh,
number
man.
One got to the outside like he wanted, but then missed the catch and couldn't capitalize on it.
Whatever.
It's third and 11.
Watch for the pass. Down.
Ace, double tight.
Number 10 will put it up again. He's pressured. Number 10 rolls outside.
Oh, we almost got it.
The D can breathe a small sigh of relief on that play, Jake. They gave up a pretty decent gain, but still managed to stop them short, and that will bring up fourth down.
They're going for it on fourth and two.
Because why not? Getting practice in with the backups. Number 10 could end up being my guy if Fife gets hurt, so.
Number 10.
Yeah, this is important reps for him.
Ready for the snap. He's pressured. Crosses middle.
Oh my god.
That's
to give not the ball fair.
Jim, they decide to go for the conversion rather than kicking it away, and they fall short.
Do you agree with the call? With the substantial lead they have, I would have punted the ball away. I sense maybe there's a bit of dislike between these two, and they want to run the score up a bit.
Ball on the 41.
19.
Number 12. Fades back. Nice block. Throw.
What?
Records his fourth grab of the game. Ball at the 33-yard line. Number 88 winds up left. Number 34. With
there we go.
That'll bring up third and short. It's third and two. The Bulldogs line up with a split backfield. Short throw down the
middle.
Number one was the intended receiver. Incomplete pass.
Number one was a yard short and a day late on that pass. It was just too far in front of him to be catchable.
Yeah, that's right.
Number 19 is ready to punt after a quick three.
Good job by my defense.
Perfect placement on the coffin corner kick to pin the opposition deep. Great kick.
They've got almost the length of the field to go here, Jake. Not the best place to start a drive, but let's see how they handle it.
Ball on the 8.
Well, got 3 yards
on
that one.
Got a few yards there off the first down carry. Well, it's not a lot, but it's tremendously important to get positive yards on first down.
7 yards to go.
It's second and about seven. The Ducks line up with their tight end right.
Okay.
Oh, great block. Number 34.
Jeez, no one blocks.
Third down.
That play was supposed to go through the three gap, but he tried to venture out of his own and got nowhere. But you got to follow your blocking patterns.
It's now third and six.
I'm going to hurt you now.
Okay. Hopefully I actually have time to throw with my backup quarterback here. Try and get triangle.
Tosses right. The pass
Number 10 had trouble with that zone in permanent lockdown. Outstanding coverage.
If he continues playing a one-man zone so well, that secondary can really topple this offensive game plan.
You know, that's right. It basically erases that receiver off the blackboard totally.
Number 38 will punt it away after a three and out. It's away. Number 35 will take it in midfield. Number 31 doesn't let that return get far as he got there in a hurry and put the return man on the turf.
The special teams are definitely winning the battle for field position
today. Why are you booing me? I'm up 49.
They've been starting in their opponent's end of the field all game long.
The Bulldogs have four wide receivers.
Come on, D.
He's pressured.
Oh, get crushed.
Works his way through and makes the sack. Big play. Ball on the 50. Number 12 drops back. Throw.
There we go.
And long.
Positive yards on that play, but they're still looking at third and long coming up.
Oregon exercises their first timeout. It's third and about seven. Number one is wide right. Number 12 will pass again. He's pressured. Dumps it off.
Oh, come on!
On the third and long, and he gets
why
the first
won't they knock
easily?
That down? 44 was there.
10 yards to go.
Ball at the 32-yard line. Number one is to the left. Number 12 is back to throw again.
He's back. Get him.
Breaks through and notches his third sack today. It's now second and 16. Number 12 fades back. He's
oh, yeah. Get some.
Through to notch the second sack of the drive. Great pursuit. It's third and about 23. He's pressured. It's
there we go. Perfect defense.
Very, very long.
Boy, somebody wasn't where they were
they
supposed to be.
They are not doing a good job with the hurry up
the
on
radar screen.
I know. What happened there?
Some serious miscommunication, I'm thinking.
Number 19 will punt yet again. Boy, is he getting a workout today.
I need a long time-consuming drive to end this game.
Number one.
Or I just need Sammy Parker to bless this punt return.
Number 70 closes in for the tackle, but that was a pretty decent return on the kick. Nice job.
Barring some kind of miracle or total meltdown, they can chalk up the win with this huge lead. They just need to chew up some time off the clock, and they can savor this one.
Ball on the 38. The Ducks have one man back. Number three is all over the field today. He makes his eighth tackle.
He was supposed to take that one through the four gap, but with a little luck and some nifty footwork, he takes it right of that and gets the yards.
Ball at the 46-yard line.
Burning clock.
Number 10 lines up under center.
Well, as expected, I had my highest scoring game of the year, and so far, my best defensive game of the year in terms of points allowed.
Escapes a tackle.
There you go, Robinson.
Run around the outside for a healthy gain and the first down.
Nice job to take this one out to the outside.
Ball on the 45.
Gotta get you more reps.
Number 34 is the lone setback.
Yeah, this has been quite the game for me on both sides of the ball. Ontario Smith had one of the freakiest first quarters that you'll ever see this season.
Number 3 is a virtual tackling machine today. That was number 10.
That was designed to go just right of his center, but he took it a mile to the right of that. Boy, Jake, if you're not going where your blockers are leading you, you're going to go nowhere.
It's 2nd and 9.
Bum, bum, bum. All right, we're either going to scramble, hit square, or hit triangle. It's going to be one of those.
He's pressured. Nice block. Number 10 on the rollout. Drops way back.
Well, there you go. Coming up. That play was not open.
It's 3rd and 9. The Ducks are set up with their tight end left. He's pressured. Spirals it right.
There you go, Kevin Willis. Good catch. Awesome catch.
Number 8 builds on a solid reception and gets even more. Let's take another look. There's the catch, and now he sees some room and takes it.
I know you agree with me, but it's so critical for an offense. Ball at the 26-yard line.
We're gonna burn more clock.
Number 8 lines up wide right. Number 34 will run it. Number 3 makes the tackle and make it an even dozen. He's been a one-man wrecking crew today. Samford exercises their first timeout. The clock shows 59 seconds left. The Ducks have two receivers in. He's pressured. Number 10 rolls out, dumps it left.
Whee! Touchdown, Sammy Parker.
Number one goes the distance to make the score. Watch here. There's the catch. But he's not interested in just a reception.
Nope, he wanted a ticket to six, and he got it. Great job.
There we go.
Number 25 sets up the extra point.
Dee-dee. Here we go. Good extra point.
There's the kick.
Boom. Right down the middle.
Adds the extra point.
Good to see the backups getting stuff done.
Oregon, with that score, are simply crushing their opponent. They lead 63-7.
3-minute drive. Touchdown.
Number 25 lines up, signals, and we're ready for the kickoff. Wow, this one's a
Boom.
Beauty.
Look at that kick.
Number 35 catches it in the end zone. Number 35 downs it in the end zone.
Not much production out of the running game today. The problem is they still have to try it if they want to keep the defense honest.
52 seconds on the clock. Number 12 steps back. He's pressured. Tosses middle. Ooh. Pass falls incomplete.
Number 22 positioned himself perfectly to act as a human fence between the quarterback and the receiver and cause the incompletion. Very impressive.
Ball on the 20. Number 12 will put it in the air again. Spirals it middle. That
there
will
we
fall
go.
Incomplete, and that's
10.
Their second in a row.
Number 88 couldn't make the catch. The ball just wasn't there for him.
Yeah, it sailed quite a bit right. Was the throw off or was the receiver not where he should have been?
Well, I'll tell you, on a bad team, the finger automatically comes out and points at each other. On a good team, they come out and point themselves.
Bro, it's caught in the flat. The 40, the 45. He's out of bounds, but the reception was made first. That's number two. Ball at the 50-yard line. Number 42 lines up off right tackle.
Come on,
number 12, he'll throw once again. He's pressured. Throw. Number four makes the tackle. It's second and two. Number 42 is off the right tackle. He's pressured, throws middle. The pass is no good, incomplete.
Number 12 strapped a jet engine into a subcompact on that throw, Jake.
Absolutely. He needs to take a deep breath so he's not rushing his throws.
Yeah, because his read, it seems good. His distance, though, way off.
It's third and two. He's pressured. Short throw down the middle. Ooh. That'll bring up fourth and short.
Number one saw that one come way in front of him.
Hey, if he knew it was coming, the receiver might have been able to sprint forward and snag it.
Yeah, but he was totally caught by surprise. You know, they need to get on the same page.
Number 19 will punt yet again. Boy, is he getting a workout today.
Boom.
Number one makes the catch. Number 26 makes the tackle, but not before a great return. Some nice open field running there. 12 seconds on the clock. He's pressured. Throw. A gain of eight. Oregon will take a timeout, and that will be their second.
Good yardage on first down, and that's always a good thing because it really opens up the playbook.
Number one lines up left. He's pressured. Number 10 rolls outside. Tosses left.
There we go. Got more yards for
they
Sammy Parker.
They side after the rollout and completed for a healthy gain. More importantly, however, they moved the chains. Nice play.
The clock has gone to zero, and this game is in the books. Oregon wins it in a runaway, 63-7.
That's yep, I look like a top 10 team in this game. That's
Jim
for
Peppers
sure.
And the crew, I'd like to thank you for tuning in to today's contest.
615 yards
of
offense for their 218.
NCAA football.
I ended up winning time of possession pretty handily, too, so not as much as I normally win it by, but it was good enough. Good enough for sure. All right, teams. So Jason Fife went 18 of 23, 284, three scores, no picks, and he had seven carries for 0 yards and a rushing touchdown. Number 10 went 7 of 10 for 126 with one score and no picks and had 4 carries for 20 yards and a touchdown. Ontario Smith had 14 carries, 167, and 3 scores. Keenan Howery had 15 catches, 206, and 3 scores. My tight end had 4 catches for 125. Sammy Parker had 5 for 60 and a score. And Kevin Willis had 1 for 19. And that's pretty much it in a nutshell. Although, what if this thing will tell me? Because I think I had a lot of tackles for loss. But it doesn't say in here, does it? No, it doesn't. I'm going to have to go look. Let's see. How many sacks did I have? 1, 2, 4, 6, 9. I had 9 sacks. Oh, my goodness. That means the tackles for loss had to be like 12 to 15 or so. Yeah, so I did pretty darn good in that game. Anyway, let's get out of here. And I have another bye week. Yay. Let's advance, though, to the game after that. So now, in the next game, we're going to be playing Arizona on the road. Hold on. This season. In the coaches' poll, I'm at number 13 now. Washington State's up to number 3. And Washington's number 19. USC is number 20. And in the media poll, Washington State's number 5. So I'm number 13 in both polls. Okay. That's cool. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and just save right now. Go ahead and save that legacy mode. And just for good measure, we're going to do it one more time because I'm anal like that. All right. All right. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching this video. And if you did, I would encourage you to subscribe to whatever channel of mine you're watching it on, whether it be on YouTube or Joshu TV or BitChute, whichever one. If you're watching, sub to the channel, check out my other videos. Although, if I have a preference, I prefer that you join me on Joshu TV and grow my channel there, because that's where a lot of my videos are that you won't see on YouTube or BitChute, and also I exclusively live stream there, so another reason to join it. And hopefully I'll be able to live stream this game again soon after the problem gets solved. Anyway, that's all for now. Toodles!